Solving your histamine intolerance could be as simple as taking the right supplements. And that's what we're going to talk about today. Hi, I'm Dr. Chris Masterjohn of chrismasterjohnphd.com, and this is Chris Masterjohn Lite, where the name of the game is details, schmetails, just tell me what works. And today we're going to talk about supplementing with diamine oxidase or kidney extract to solve your histamine intolerance. Now, if you're not caught up to speed on histamine intolerance, briefly, histamine intolerance is symptoms such as headaches, diarrhea, or anything reminiscent of allergies in response to histamine in foods. I listed out the foods and the symptoms in more detail in a previous episode, and I will link to that in the description of this episode. When you eat foods that have histamine, the normal response is for diamine oxidase, an enzyme that is made in many places in your body, but is found in extremely high amounts in the gut. When your intestinal cells just keep pumping diamine oxidase into your intestines, and so it neutralizes all the histamine before you absorb it, normally when you're healthy. If you eat foods and the histamine gets through into your system to increase your systemic histamine levels and contribute to symptoms such as headache or diarrhea or any of the allergies, flushing, itching, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera, that suggests that the histamine is not being fully neutralized in your gut and suggests that you may have low diamine oxidase activity. A quick and simple test of this, and also a way to get rid of the symptoms acutely while you try to figure out what might be going on underneath the surface, is to supplement with diamine oxidase. And there are two supplements that I'll recommend. You can try either of them and see which one is more effective for you. The first is Seeking Health Histamine Block, which is a diamine oxidase activity supplement, and Ancestral Supplements Kidney Extract, which is not specifically diamine oxidase, but it is the extract of kidney tissue, as if you were eating kidneys, which is something our ancestors did. And kidney has the highest amount of diamine oxidase activity. So out of the organ meats, eating kidney is where you get the most of that. I will link in the description to each of these products, and you can use chrismasterjohnphd.com/DAO for the histamine block, or chrismasterjohnphd.com/kidney for the ancestral kidney supplement. Those are affiliate links, and if you use them at no extra cost to you, I will get a small commission that will support all the free work that I do. If you do not want to use affiliate links, just Google these products and you'll be able to find them. For full disclosure, Ancestral Supplements is also a sponsor of this podcast, although they played no role in the decision for me to recommend their supplement or played any role in any of the content that I put out. When you take these supplements, for the Seeking Health Histamine Block, I would use one capsule per meal or per histamine-rich meal. And for the Ancestral Kidney, I would try two. And I would take them within 15 minutes or so before the meal, so that when the food is incoming, the DAO is in your gut. And see if it helps. If it does help, that does two things. Number one, you found a quick fix. You can manage your symptoms without knowing anything further. And then number two, it gives you a big clue to the problem, because if taking DAO so that it's in your gut helps get rid of that histamine so that it doesn't cause a problem, that means, or at least strongly suggests, that one of the underlying problems is that you don't have enough DAO in your gut. If that's the case, then you can look now to long-term strategies. So first of all, the cofactors for diamine oxidase are vitamin B6, copper, and vitamin C. I had previously done episodes on how to manage your status for each of those. I'll link to those episodes in the description of this one. But looking at those makes a special sense when your DAO activity appears to be low, because you might have a vitamin C, B6, or copper deficiency that, if you fix it, will support your DAO and will allow you to not have to use these supplements as often. On the other hand, sometimes the reason that DAO activity is low is because there's damage to the gut. In that case, you might need to focus on healing your gut, and that can be a very nuanced picture that is very specific to you as an individual, and you should probably work with a healthcare practitioner who specializes in gut healing to do that. But some of the approaches that might be most helpful would include focusing on foods that do not cause GI distress for you, focusing on a nutrient-dense diet to make sure that you're getting everything that you need, and using collagen or bone broth and glutamine supplementation, and perhaps the right probiotic. Figuring out exactly the cause of low DAO activity and fixing it could be a long road and perhaps a complicated one. I hope the tips that I've offered make it a slower and easier road. But in the meantime, if the DAO supplementation does work, then at least you have a short-term fix that can improve your quality of life while you're figuring the other things out. All right, I hope you found this useful. Signing off, this is Chris Masterjohn of chrismasterjohnphd.com. This has been Chris Masterjohn Lite, and I will see you in the next episode.